I'm honored to add my voice to the very impressive group gathered tonight to save one of New York City and America's great cultural treasures, Birdland, and to support the small music venues and theaters that keep the arts alive. Ever since Birdland's namesake, Charlie Parker, headlined its opening in 1949, it's been one of the most important jazz clubs in the world, giving a stage to established legends and up-and-comers alike. I think Parker would have liked that. He was a young man in 1949. Last year, we celebrated the 100th anniversary of his birth. Now we celebrate in a world where the pandemic has taken a huge toll on small business, and especially on venues that rely on an audience to hear live music or see a play. But the desire to experience great art in person is a big reason why so many of us have taken this pandemic so seriously, so that we can once again safely enjoy the things we love, the things that connect us to our common humanity and make life more beautiful. With the development of multiple safe and effective vaccines, there is a light at the end of this tunnel. What a tragedy it would be to lose one of our great venues now, when the end of the long nightmare is within reach. I know all of us want places like Birdland to be a part of our lives for the rest of our lives. I hope we want the same for our children. Just now, we have the opportunity to make sure that happens. And when the day comes that the clubs, theaters, and other venues can open their doors again, the music will sound even sweeter. Thank you.
Thank you. music from Birdland, the jazz corner of the world.
Right here, Birdland at the jazz corner of the world. The Bill Evans Trio.
Ella Fitzgerald.
I know what you're doing.
Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, and Bud Powell, Roy Haynes are all together in one group.
This is a special presentation.
Save Birdland, a celebration of music, history, and community.
This is Save Birdland.
With performances from the worlds of jazz, pop,
country, stage, screen,
and beyond.
Featuring a cast of hundreds and coming to you from the jazz corner of the world
and direct from the stars' homes.
Sit back, relax, and enjoy tonight's special presentation.
Welcome to the Birdland stage, Catherine Russell with the Emmett Cohen Trio.
Lullaby in Birdland, that's what I always hear when you sigh. Never in my wordland could that be words to reveal in a phrase how I feel. Have you ever heard two turtle doves, bill and coo, when they love? That's the kind of magic music we'll make with our lips when we kiss. I am as a weepy old willow, he really knows how to cry. That's how I cry in my pillow. If you should tell me farewell and goodbye. Lullaby of Birdland, whisper low. Kiss me sweet, then we'll go. Flying high in Birdland, high in the sky, up above. All because we're in sweet, then we'll go. Flying high in Birdland, high in the sky, up above. Oh, because we're in love.
Music is the great unifier. It crosses all cultures, all languages, all backgrounds. Great music brings us together. And live music venues are the heart and soul of a community. New York City has been home to some of the greatest anywhere in the world. The Cotton Club, the Copacabana, Max's Kansas City, CBGB, Studio 54, Limelight. This list goes on and on. But you know who has outlived them all is Birdland. Since December of 1949, Birdland has been the jazz corner of the world. It's one of the greatest nightclubs in the history of music. And it's been that way for over 70 years, where people have flocked from all corners of the earth to feel the magic that emanates from that stage. The energy of everyone who's ever played there, it's still in the air. Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, Miles Davis, John Coltrane, Sarah Vaughan, Sonny Rollins, Ella, Billy, the list is everyone who was anyone. They all played Birdland, and they didn't just play Birdland, they recorded their albums there. You know, the bird in Birdland is a tribute to Charlie Bird Parker, but given all she's been through, all she's survived, I think the bird in Birdland might just be the phoenix, and with your help, she can rise from the ashes of this difficult time stronger than ever before. My friends, this horrible pandemic will end and we will all be together again soon. We're here tonight to make sure Birdland survives. And whenever her grand reopening is, I'll be right there in the audience with you. So please give what you can, stay safe, and let's keep the music playing.
John Pizzarelli is up next, right here on Save Birdland.
Hey everybody, it's John Pizzarelli. My last gig in New York City was March 12th, 2020 at Birdland. And I'm looking forward to my next gig in New York being at Birdland too, and I'm looking forward to making meatballs for everybody there. Here's a little Nat Cole. Here's something that I'd like to bring to you, wrapped all in cellophane designed for you. Tell what it's all about, it is without a doubt, swinging in the latest style, service with a smile. If you want to swing and shout, get your kicks and get about, I'm an errand boy for rhythm, send me lace your boots and follow through, I'll deliver straight to you, I'm an errand boy for rhythm, send me. You can always find me down at Smokey Joe's. That's the place where every gal and gator goes. So if you want variety, just step in and call for me. I'm an errand boy for rhythm. Send me.
For all your generosity. So many of you have... Should I have my mask on?
Oh, I should.
Well, we live together.
No, hold on.
We're in a bubble.
We need to say... Hello! You go first.
Hi, I'm Tom Dangora.
And I am Michael Dangora.
We're the producers of this wild and crazy evening with the great Tim Guinee, who isn't here right now because he lives upstate. I wore a black turtleneck because of jazz.
I wore sparkles.
We are so grateful to so many people. So many people have donated their time, their talent, their money, their social media. As you saw at the beginning and at the end, there's going to be a lot of special thanks. If we forgot to thank any of you, it's because we're bad people. No, it's really not. It's because we put this together in 9 seconds and we had so much to do. But if you weren't thanked, no, we're thanking you in our heart and we're thanking you right this second. Thank you.
We are so excited about the numbers we have coming your way tonight. We have amazing performances from the world of jazz, pop, Broadway, country, you name it.
You name it.
We have
it. Name something. Name a genre.
I don't think we have rap.
I can't rap.
We have performances coming from this stage right here upstairs at Birdland. We have performances from the new theater downstairs, which is gorgeous.
Gorgeous! We have performances coming from people's homes. We have a couple performances from other empty theaters because people wanted stage and lights. We have... bits. We have bits. Oh my God.
We have
You're
going
to see bits.
We have
There's
segments.
Bits.
If you've contributed to this fund already, thank you, thank you, thank you.
We thank you.
If you haven't contributed yet, please consider doing so. Hopefully the performances tonight will inspire you.
Oh, they will.
And hopefully they'll show you what an amazing institution Birdland is.
Stay with us. Please keep donating at the link below.
From the Jazz Corner of the World, we are so honored that you are here tonight. Sit back, relax, have a cocktail, and enjoy some great music.
Is that good? Did you get us?
Awesome.
Okay, thank you.
Next up, we have the Steve Wilson Quintet.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Steve Wilson, and joining me is the great Sullivan Fortner on piano, Ugona Akegwo on the contrabass, Chris Smith on drums, Dave DeJesus on alto saxophone, and we're going to play a tune by the great alto saxophonist Charlie Parker. This is entitled Quasimodo. Thank you.
watching Save Birdland. I'm Paul Cavalcante, and this is Peter Cincotti with Heart of the City.
As a native New Yorker, I grew up coming to Birdland ever since I was a kid. I saw so many performers here that influenced me through the years, and I do not want to think of a New York City without Birdland. For so many music lovers, this place is the heart of the city, and I'm going to play for you a song I wrote called Heart of the City. We got to keep it beating. From the concrete canyons in the Bronx to the park at Battery, runs a river made of living dreams and the blood of history. No matter what it is you're looking for, it's here, and you can find a day or night. Roses at the grocery store, in case you fall in love. There's a psychic on the second floor who could give you fate a shove. Everybody here remembers that one day, and we know what it is to fight. And the heart of the city, it beats on, yeah, it beats on like a drum. In the shadow of the Brooklyn Bridge, a couple shares a kiss, while a father in East Harlem takes his son to see the Knicks, and a writer down on Broadway plays the keys just like this. And the heart of the city, everybody here is right where we belong. New York strong, New York strong, and the heart of the city.
Strange to be be hearing from somebody from outside the world of jazz about what's going on with the music places in New York, and particularly Birdland. Of course, I share my life with a jazz pianist, so this is very, very close to my heart. And my boys are American-born New Yorkers. I want there to be a place for them to hear the finest music that America has to offer, that the world has to offer. It doesn't seem very long ago that I was sitting with Diana and Phil Lesh of the Grateful Dead listening to Cedar Walton. Now, that's not an evening you can readily imagine, but that's just one of the things that can happen when you find yourself inside a place like Birdland. So that little motif I opened with is a song I wrote a long time ago called The Birds Will Still Be Singing. And I truly believe it will. So I know there's a lot as we hope to hold on to our sanity and our decency and our love for one another. There's a lot that calls for those pennies in your pocket right now. But let's all pull together and make sure that when we're all back well again and feel safe, that we still have all those wonderful venues to go and visit and enjoy some more evenings like that. All right, I'll see you very soon.
Looking now at Times Square in old New York City. It's the hub of the entertainment world, around which are clustered movie houses, legitimate theaters, and nightclubs, which serve as the settings for performers in all areas of show business. One of these areas, of course, is jazz. And in New York, the setting for great jazz is a spot called Birdland, just up Broadway off Times Square. It's the jazz corner of the world. And I have just been sneaked over here. Here we come down the steps of the world-famous jazz spot, Birdland. This is just for you to walk if you ever get to New York and drop in, and you'll stop here and pay. Hello there.
Hi.
What's your name?
Nancy.
Want to stamp my hand? Remember when they used to do that with the purple stamp? You can probably hear the strains of 1 o'clock jump in the background, and that means count is here. What do you say, Pee-wee?
How you feel, Mr. Allen?
Who's here tonight?
We have Count Basie, Johnny Smith, and Joe Williams.
Let's get up and see what's going on.
Hi, Steve.
How you doing? Things are jumping here tonight, huh?
Well, I see.
Well, that's good. Well, I don't want to slow it down any. What do you say we get right into the record for which there have probably been more requests thrown at you this year than any in a long time, a thing called April in Paris. Y'all set?
Roll.
Here it is, live.
In the late 1920s, the music scene saw a dramatic shift as more and more of the world's top musicians moved from Chicago to New York, making it the jazz mecca of the world. Since then, almost every major jazz style of the past 70 years was born right here in the Big Apple.
The original Birdland opened 71 years ago at 52nd and Broadway on December 15, 1949. Charlie Parker was the headliner, and Harry Belafonte and Lester Young were also on the bill.
It was Charlie Parker, whose fans and fellow musicians called him Bird, a contraction of his more formal nickname, Yardbird, who served as the inspiration of the naming of the club, Birdland.
In addition to Bird, many jazz legends were regulars at the club. Count Basie and his smokin' big band made Birdland their New York headquarters, and eventually they recorded George Shearing's Lullaby of Birdland at the club.
Charlie Parker's classic quartet regularly appeared in the early 1960s recording live at Birdland.
And famous DJ Symphony Sid Torrance made his name broadcasting from the club to radio listeners throughout the Eastern Seaboard.
In its first 5 years of existence, 1,400,000 people paid the $1.50 admission to hear jazz luminaries and up-and-comers. Given the artists that played there, it comes as no surprise.
Birdland's booking history reads like a who's who of jazz. Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, Thelonious Monk, Sarah Vaughan, Ella Fitzgerald, Miles Davis, John Coltrane, Bud Powell, Stan Getz, Lester Young, Errol Garner, and many, many others.
There's a reason it earned its moniker, the Jazz Corner of the World.
Birdland generated excitement on a daily basis. So it's no surprise the club attracted its share of celebrities.
Regulars to the club included household names such as Gary Cooper, Marilyn Monroe, Frank Sinatra, Joe Louis, Marlena Dietrich, Ava Gardner, Sammy Davis Jr.
As Alan Morrison, longtime editor of Ebony, once put it, Birdland was a cultural vantage point and a barometer of trends where all the big names in jazz performed.
But as a new popular music, rock and roll, emerged, Birdland's fortunes declined in the 60s and its doors were closed on Broadway and 52nd Street in 1965. It wouldn't be until the mid-80s before Birdland was reborn.
This is Christine Pedi on Save Birdland. Charlie Parker would introduce our next performer as the singer with the million-dollar ears. Here's Sheila Jordan with I Got Rhythm.
Miss Jordan, to the stage, please, for I Got Rhythm.
Jazz music alive, and this beautiful club, Birdland, that club has been around for many, many years, since the early 50s, when all the greats played there. Yes, they did. It was Bird, and also Max Roach, Tommy Potter, Miles Davis, Dizzy Gillespie. Yes, it was. Birdland was on 52nd Street. I moved to New York when I was very young. I think that I was about 18. Jazz clubs on 52nd Street, oh my God. It was so neat. And guess what? They had rhythm. They had music. They had bebop. Who could ask for anything more? They had Daisy in green pastures. They had bebop. Who could ask for anything more? Oh, old man trouble. Well, I don't mind him. You won't find him round my door. I got starlight. I got sweet dreams. I got bebop. Who could ask for anything more? The booty, the bed, 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 the I don't know that it's a little bit.
Scott Bradley and Sonny Holiday are up next, right here on Save Birdland.
Hey folks, Scott Bradley from Postmodern Cheekbox here, and I am so excited to be part of such a great event for such an important cause. Birdland is one of the most legendary, historic jazz venues. There's so much history there, and it is absolutely vital that we save it and preserve it for future generations to enjoy. Like lots of musicians, I cut my teeth in New York City. I have so many fond memories of going over to Birdland and seeing amazing shows and even taking part in Jim Caruso's amazing cast party open mic night. In fact, there was a time that I went there and I played a mashup of all these 80s songs done as ragtime piano. And I think since it's been about 10 years, I'm gonna dust off this piano, see if I can do it again tonight.
All right, folks, next up, we've got a fellow that plays in that hip new style that all those TikTok toe kids are dancing to these days. You guessed it, ragtime. Now, please put your hands together for Mr. Scott Bradley. Take it away, Scott.
necesito esta noche y te necesito más que nunca. Y abrázame duro, mi amor. No aguantamos para siempre, felices por una eternidad. No nos equivocamos, juntos vamos donde se termine esta línea. Tu amor es como una sombra por mí toda mi vida. I cry in Spanish tonight. Para siempre lloraré en español. Para siempre lloraré. Once upon a time I was falling in love. Now I'm only falling apart. Nothing I can do. Total eclipse of the heart.
Talking about Birdland, it's classic. It is part of the soul of New York. It's one of the greatest clubs that I've been into in the world. The food is great, the music is great. We're trying to keep all these places that are iconic, that are great, that give people so much joy, something to look forward to, not just the musicians. It's New Yorkers. It's tourists, it's people that are coming in. It's part of everything. It's all connected. So we're really just trying to dig into our hearts and do whatever we can. We don't want it to go anywhere. We don't want that out of our lives. Show your support in any way that you can, even if it's they're trying to save Birdland, they're trying to keep it going. Just saying that and just put that out there so everybody can get that feeling, that emotion. That is also a way of helping. It's a creative way. But let everybody know we're there on common purpose. Thank you so much. We solely appreciate it.
Hi, my name is Chris Matheson, and I've been a part of the Birdland family since 2005. Man, do I miss this place, and I miss you all. I thought today I would teach you how to make our signature cocktail. The Yardbird Sweet, named after Charlie Yardbird Parker, is our key lime pie martini. First, it gets a splash of lemon juice and a splash of lime juice. This adds a nice little tang to the cocktail.
Ooh, yummy.
Splash of pineapple juice, a splash of milk or heavy cream. Get the splash of triple sec, orange flavored liqueur, and a nice healthy pour of vanilla vodka, about 3 ounces. Delicious and nutritious. All right, we shake that up. Cocktail served in a martini glass that I had chilling. Strain that up.
Wow.
And lastly, garnish with a lime.
Oh.
And there it is, the Yardbird Suite. Be safe, I miss you. I can't wait to see you when Birdland reopens.
This is Rhonda Hamilton. Coming up next on Save Birdland, a celebration of music, history, and community, is Jane Monheit.
Max Hamer arranged this especially for this evening. This is a song from Bye Bye Birdie. This is called Put on a Happy Face. Gray skies are gonna clear up. Put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up. Put on a happy face. Take off the gloomy mask of tragedy, it's not your style. You look so good that you'll be glad you decided to smile. Pick out a pleasant outlook, stick out the noble chin, wipe off that full of doubt look, slap on a happy grin, and spread sunshine all over the place. So happy singers don't sit and whine. Pick up banana splits and licorice and you'll feel fine. I knew a girl so gloomy, she'd never live a sing. She wouldn't listen to me, now she's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place, just put on a heavy
was so much fun. Thank you so much. Save Birdland.
This is Emilio Sanchez from Los Originales on La FM Radio. You're tuned in to Save Birdland. Next up, we have Kenneth Asher with the Rainbow Connection.
I am delighted to be back here at Birdland, and I'm equally delighted to play this song that Paul Williams and I wrote a few years ago.
Hi, I'm Johnny Valenti, and I'm the owner at Birdland. Birdland is 71 years old, and I've had the honor of owning it for the last 35 years. And in 1983, I had the pleasure of meeting Charlie's widow, Doris Parker. Her knowledge for music was amazing. She lived for music. She lived to help artists and everyone enjoy life. And she would constantly come in and visit me at my restaurant on the Upper West Side. And we always spoke about reopening Charlie's Bandstand. And I come from a family of musicians, and ironically, my father was an alto sax player as well, and he loved Charlie Parker. So it was very intriguing to me, and I pursued the idea, and with Doris's help, along with Max Roach, we reopened June 19th, 1985 on 105th Street. That night was very exciting, not only for me and many of Charlie's friends that he had played with at the original Birdland. It was almost surreal to look on stage and seeing the great Milt Jackson and his quartet. I could only imagine what my dad must have felt being a lover of jazz, coming from Europe, and just wanting to hear everything he could ever want. For me, walking in through the doors every day is like going into church. This pandemic has thrown everyone out of whack. The first thing that I thought about when I had to close my doors are my employees. What's going to happen to my chef, my dishwashers, my managers, the piano tuner, people that have been with me, my teammates? It was worrisome. I didn't know what I was going to do. I know this pandemic has hit the whole world, and your generosity has not been lost. Birdland is much bigger than I am, but it's been an honor and a privilege to be a part of this club for the last 35 years. You know, when I think back of meeting Doris Parker and our friendship that we developed, I am so honored and blessed that she trusted me to carry on Charlie's tradition. And I remember having lunch with her and Max Roach, and I said to both of them, I said, I want to do this, but I think I can only do it for 50 years. Is that good enough? And they both smiled and said, yeah, that'll be plenty. Thanks to those who have contributed, we're going to hit the 50-year mark. I'm Johnny Valenti, and from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank everyone for their love and support.
Literally bringing her entire family to the party, here is Sweden's Queen of Swing, Gunhild Carling, and her darlings.
Hello, Birdland. We're going to send this to Birdland. Hello, Birdland. Birdland, are you there, Birdland? We love you. I miss you so much. I miss you and Gianni. I miss you so much. And here is a song for you, and it's Your Smile Makes a Difference to My Life. I composed this song for you. Okay. Ah. Okay. Are you now ready?
I could be movie star, I could be queen in every bar, but your smile is the difference to my life. I could win £1 million or two, fly from UK to Kathmandu, still your smile makes the difference to my life. So happy around you, so happy I found you, my life's but one concern. A pressure to throw you, the pleasure I owe you of happiness in return. There is no prize nor competition compared to you before my vision. Your smile makes the difference to my life. Yeah.
That's how long Birdland has existed. Jazz, singers, improv, movement, 71 years. The original Birdland was on Broadway. I was in Mr. Wonderful at the time, and Sammy Davis Jr. I became fascinated and interested in jazz, even though I was a ballet dancer with a ponytail. The sound, and it's so American. I can't believe I'm talking about, Dizzy Gillespie would laugh if he heard me saying at my age now, because I was I was older than a teenager when I met Dizzy Gillespie at the original Birdland. But then all of a sudden, that closed. I'm walking down 44th Street and there is Birdland, and it was huge, gorgeous, first of all. It's expanded, it's gotten more comfortable for all of us, not just jazz. I've danced on that stage. So I'm asking you to donate whatever you can to keep Birdland. Birdland, the word Birdland. New York should have a Birdland. Every city should have a Birdland, because Birdland is important to New York City, to the music industry, to the artist. I need it. Maybe I'm being selfish. I'm not being selfish. So I'm asking you to be proud of what you've got and to keep it. And in order to keep it in this day and age, you have to donate. Birdland needs to exist forever, as far as I'm concerned. Keep Birdland alive and swinging. Thank you for whatever it is that you can afford to give.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to hear a song about music, booze, blow, ing blues, swingers, licks, noodling, late nights, smoky clubs, and a cast of cool cats straight out of Times Square, all the things we hold near and dear to our hearts. Thank you.
Yeah. Fairchild. Listen, I am so enjoying the show tonight. I just thought I'd call in with a request. Could you play something by my favorite crooner, Billy Stritch?
You got it. Here's Billy Stritch with Blue Again.
Here's a song written by Wayne Hahn and Joel Lindsay. Skies will be blue again. Just you wait and see, it's all new again. For you and for me, all these hard days will end, and our gray skies will be blue again. So we'll just muddle on to the clouds and the rain have just up and gone, and we'll make it through until then, when our gray skies will be blue again. Every single tear and every single dream that fell down from the stars in your eyes will soon disappear, and all this will seem like a million miles away. From the dark stormy skies will be blue again. Just look, it's happening now. Yes, it's true again. The sun shines somehow through our sadness and pain, and our gray skies will be blue again. And we'll look back at this, and we'll just have to smile at the sudden bliss that reminds us of how and of when every gray sky will be blue again. The sun shines somehow through our sadness and pain, and our gray skies will be blue again. And we'll look back at this, and we'll just have to smile at the sudden bliss that reminds us of how and of when every gray sky will be blue again. Every gray sky will be blue again.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is Stacy Kent.
What's it all about?
Alfie, is it just for the moment we live? What's it all about when you sort it out, Alfie? Are we meant to take more than we give? Or are we meant to be kind? And if only fools are kind, Alfie, then I guess it is wise to be cruel. But if life belongs only to the strong, Alfie, what will you lend on an old golden rule? As sure as I there's a heaven above, Alfie, I know there's something much more, something even non-believers can be. I believe in love, Alfie. Without true love, we just exist, Alfie. Until you find the love you've missed, you're nothing, Alfie. When you walk, let your heart lead the way, and you'll find love any day, Alfie.
Jazz has always been a dialogue between musicians. Rooted in the blues and ragtime, it tells stories of triumph and hardship. It tells stories of the haves and the have-nots. It's truly an American language that grows and changes with each generation. And right now, we have to ensure that it plays on. Music clubs give a platform for musicians to collaborate and share their stories. They give audiences a place to reflect on the times or forget their troubles. And whether you are an artist or an audience member, Birdland, with your help, will be there for you when it's safe to gather again. Thank you for donating to help keep the doors of this historic club.
I'm Paul Cavalcante, and next up we have a real treat for you. Here's the incomparable George Coleman.
Thank you. Carter and me, and here's me also. on behalf of Birdland, my favorite club in Manhattan, 44th Street between 8th and 9th Avenue. I've played many gigs there. I've had great fun with my quartet and my trio, Michelle LeGrand, my big band, Doug Provence, lead the band trombone. We really are a great bunch of guys, and I've heard great music there, upstairs and down, with a very good restaurant. They're having some difficulty now, as are most business in the States, and now New York is affecting the musicians. We need a place to play. We love playing at Birdland. I love playing at Birdland. As my friend would say, yes, he loves playing at Birdland also. They're having a GoFundMe event, and we're asking you, our fans, our audience, our support of the music, to please contribute. I look forward to the day when you can come by and say hello live. In the meantime, let's keep Birdland happening. They'd appreciate your support, as I have always appreciated your support for the music. Now we're looking for your support to make the club still stand when it's time to go back to work. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hi everyone, it's Julie Halston, just sitting around and musing about Birdland. Birdland is like my second home. It represents everything about New York that I love: artistry, glamour, and community. And you know, there is nothing more exciting to me than being on the Birdland stage and imparting the words of wisdom from Joan Crawford. Joan Crawford lived in New York before she went to Hollywood, and she understood how exciting and wonderful New York could be. So again, I impart these words of wisdom from Joan to you today. My life in New York was complete. I was dancing, and that was the main thing. And oh yes, we had stage door Johnnies. Oh yes, we had good times. They knew how to treat a girl right. So why think about Hollywood? It sounded to me like another tank town, and I'd had enough of those. And the money wasn't bad. In those days in New York, food and rent didn't eat up all your dough. So there was some left over for nice clothes. And there was a certain excitement just being in a theater or a nightclub. It didn't seem to matter whether you were legit, vaudeville, or burlesque. People gave you special treatment. There was an excitement, a respect. Seems to be gone today. I mean, there were boarding houses that would let us stay there on the cuff when we were out of work. And the men dated us expected to spend money on us. And there was no bad scene if we didn't live up to their expectations. Candy, flowers, great dinners, even furs. We got them all in New York. Well, we may not have stage door Johnnies, but we have Gianni. And that's enough for us. Please support Birdland. It's everything we love about New York.
Save Birdland is excited to welcome Jim Caruso's cast party.
I'd dance and I'd sing, I'd do anything just to get my name in lights. I gotta try to hit the heights now that I'm free as a breeze again. Old nimble knees again. And soon they'll all know my name. I'll have fortune and fame when I get my name in lights. It can happen overnight in these modern times. Here in the jazz age, the world is at a crazy stage.
You can be famous and cause a panic
if you slick back your hair and then you fly the Atlantic. And that's why we won't let go till we're on the radio. And when you come to see the sights,
And that'll be our name spelled right, lighting up Times Square.
I will sit on a flagpole,
whatever the rage, just to get my face on the front page, and just to get my name in lights.
Well, hi, my name is Jim Caruso. This is Billy Stritch. That is Tom Hubbard. We've been hosting an event here every single Monday for 17 years called Cast Party. It's an open mic night variety show with some of the greatest people, Broadway, jazz, cabaret, pop, you name it, they've come through the door. Everyone from Liza Minnelli to a woman who wrote a song about her feet. It's come what mayhem, people.
We're living life from this very day. New York, we're on our way.
We'll be known for our charm
and our sparkling wit. Even Eartha Kitt will admit we got it.
When I get my name.
When I get my name.
When I get my name.
In lights. I got to get my name in lights.
I want to give you a little taste of some of the amazing talent that shows up at Cast Party on Monday nights. This is not just your basic open mic night. We have everybody from superstars to up-and-comers. Okay, Kristy Neversole, Tony Award winner. Here she is.
When you're in love and you are wondering if he really is the one, there's an ancient sign sure to tell you that your search is over and done. Catch a bee, and if he don't sting you, you're in a spell that's just begun. True love you have won. When a bee lies sleeping in the palm of your hand, and deep in love's long looked after land, where you'll see a sun up sky with a morning moon, and the days go laughing by when love comes a calling on you. Sleep on me.
Stephanie J. Block, and I love, love, love Birdland. New York, 44th Street. It wouldn't be the same without Birdland. I made my Broadway debut in 2003 playing Liza Minnelli, and I was desperate to share my authentic voice and my sensibility and my own face.
And Jim Caruso took me under his wing and he said, I think I've got a stage for you and I'd love to help develop your solo show. And we did that. And from that moment on, it has allowed me a whole different way of expressing this art form, and it has been a godsend to me. Birdland has been a godsend to me and so many other artists. Night after night, magic is happening on that stage, whether it's on the jazz scene, the Broadway scene, the cabaret scene. And I am so grateful that those doors will continue to be open when it's safe for all of us to gather again and be with some of the hippest, swellest, most talented people. So thank God for it, for you, for everybody who pitched in to save this legendary place. We're forever grateful.
Up next at Cast Party, the very witty Amanda Green.
You know, things are really looking up. Joe and Kamala were inaugurated. We're going to save Birdland. And in one short week, do you know what it's going to be? February. Oh, Merry February. How my heart soars when I'm stuck indoors, 'cause it's February. Here's to February, whose pleasures are remote. Skies are as dingy and gray as my once white winter coat. In February, festive February. Faces pale and eyes sunken or bloated and drunken in February. It's that time of year when holiday cheer is a distant memory. Christmas has long been past, spring will never come to be. Only February, years of February. When a rodent holds sway on that gay Groundhog's Day in February, flaccid February, like a ball that's lost its bounce, with that one extra R that makes it so hard to pronounce. February, mellifluous February. Every fourth year, hooray, we get one extra day of February. Even Valentine's is little recompense, with its dashed expectations and Duane Reed sentiments. It comes once a year, there's no way to duck it. After 28 days, even God said, oh, fuck it. I can't with February. That's my rant with February. As I pace the halls and look for more walls to climb. Wake me up when we stop daylight saving time. Hello everyone,
my name is Colleen Ballinger and I play a character called Miranda Sings. Over the last decade, I have had so many incredible opportunities because of this weird character that I have created on the internet. I have gained millions of followers online. I've been able to write and create and produce my own Netflix show and a Netflix comedy special. I've written books, done world tours. I have done so many incredible, wonderful, exciting things in my career that I feel so blessed to have had the opportunity to do. And I full-heartedly believe that I would have not had the opportunities that I had if it were not for Birdland and the experiences that I had there. When my first video went viral online, I got a message from Jim Caruso asking if I would ever be interested in performing at Birdland at an open mic night. And I was so excited that he had messaged me because I obviously had heard of Birdland before because it's such an iconic, incredible place. And so I jumped at the chance, flew out to New York City from California, Alaina and performed for the very first time live as my character Miranda Sings. Up until that point, I had only performed in my bedroom for the camera for people on the internet. And performing on that stage at Birdland was the first time I felt a spark of passion and excitement and love and acceptance for this weird character that I had created, and my career was born. I owe so much of my success to my experiences at Birdland. After that first performance at Birdland, I came back so many times to perform, and every single performance was so fun and unique and different and exciting. I got to perform with so many incredible celebrities and have just magical experiences on that stage and in that room with incredible fans. That stage is where I created my one-woman show, which is what I eventually started touring with. There are so many incredible memories that I have had the honor of having at Birdland, and there is no way I'm just gonna sit by and let this magical place disappear. I'm not the only person who has had incredible experiences at Birdland. I have watched so many incredible things happen there. I've watched some of the best performances I've ever seen in my entire life. I've watched theater kids get inspired and be able to perform in front of their idols sitting right in front of them. Birdland is where I found my first manager. I mean, there are so many exciting things that happened for me there in my career, but also just incredible memories that I've had with friends that I will hold so dear to my heart forever. I am going to be donating, and I really hope that you can too. This isn't just a place where people go perform. This is a place where dreams can come true, careers can be started, passions can be ignited, and memories can be made forever that can change your life. I mean that with my whole heart. I love Birdland. I don't want to see it go. If you can donate anything, please do.
And to wrap up Cast Party tonight, the amazing, Tony-winning Lilias-White.
Hey, Billy. How you doing?
I'm great. How are you, honey?
I'm doing great. You know, that sounds like a song that I sang in a show called Like Jazz that was written by Cy Coleman with lyrics by Alan and Marilyn Bergman.
What could be better?
Oh, it's a great song. And I'm dedicating this to everybody who's out there who loves live music in live places like Birdland. Ah, don't you wish you could do that? Ooh, sounds so good. Right here. Those hands, amazing how they find the music in his mind. Two hands that sometimes sound like four. Some nights you swear there may be more. Those hands, they look like yours or mine. 10 fingers, same design, but they know things that ours don't know. And they go places ours can't go. Those hands, that cat's a killer of a kitten on the keys. He's just a modulating fool. To play Blue Moon in 7 flats for him's a breeze. I may exaggerate, but you'll go wild at those arpeggios. Every night they come from near and far. You hear them ooh and ah. Around his Yamaha. I mean, those hands, our Tatum would approve. The way his fingers move when making love to Sweet Lorraine. Their place in history is secure. Those hands, who would you trust to manicure? Those hands. That's Billy Stritch, y'all. I swear, nobody navigates those notes with so much ease as if that pair of hands had wings. And when I watch them fly across
Well, thanks for watching the cast party portion of Save Birdland. We can't wait to see you back here on stage on Monday night when the coast is clear. So from Billy Stritch and me, enjoy the rest of the show.
Hello, friends of Birdland. My name is Justin Robertson, also known as Squigs. I'm an illustrator celebrating the performing arts and the communities they create. The Birdland community is incredibly special, especially on Monday nights at Cast Party. On occasion, Jim invites me in for a special night when I'll draw each performer as they do their thing. It's my little way of cheering on this amazing community and hopefully helping out some great charities. So when we're all back at Birdland in person, I hope to see you there. But in the meantime, here's some quick sketching of the fab folks you've just seen. Thanks so much for helping to keep Birdland in flight.
I'm Paul Cavalcante, and it's a real honor to introduce our next guest. You're watching Save Birdland, and this is Kurt Elling.
Every day bleeds away when I face it without you. Every day's gray and I run away from sunshine's rays without you. Every song's minor and tragic. That's every day that goes by without your magic. I'm drowning under the weight of the clock's ticking. It's crushing all my dreams and all my little hopes of loving. It's a beating of beats that repeats and repeats, and it keeps me from knowing some peace. And the night would be quite alright with me now. It's too much, it's too long, it's too strong, breathing without seeing you. Eating nothing, smoking all my little cigarettes up. My mama done told me just to come on home. Oh, no! How to go on living knowing my light is where you are. And just then you walk through my door. Eyes and happiness is just a kiss away, a smile from you. I'm just a happy pappy, don't need no map, just come closer now. Let's take a trip aboard that ship. There's islands of love awaiting lonely lovers who venture onto the sea. Famous for loving, just two sweethearts doing the thing. Clark Kent and his Lois Lane, Roxanne for Cyrano de Bergerac, Tarzan in his Jane. They held on till they could swing it. Boris and the tall Natasha, Captain Smith and Pocahontas magnetically laid. As it goes. baby. My world's empty when I'm without you, so can't you keep closer to me? Lover's bouquet. Just so it's clear to say, as long as you can stay, I'll be happy with you. You'll be happy too. It's a make or break for heaven's sake, 'cause there's no faking love. It's a date, every date, to let love make a way. So just promise you can stay.
We hope you're enjoying tonight's program. I'm Emilio Sanchez from Los Originales on La FM Radio, and this is Natalie Douglas and Brian Nash with the Etta James classic, At Last.
A dream that I could call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I had never known. You smiled. In heaven, for you are mine at last. I found a dream that I could speak to, a dream that I could call my own. I found a thrill. Thank you.
guests for tonight's special presentation. Here is Clint Holmes.
So too. All
right.
Yeah.
Shall we do it?
Yeah, the Christian Taver wrote this arrangement.
All right.
Yeah. Here we go. Looking back on when I was a little nappy-headed boy. So then my only worry was for Christmas, what would be my toy? Now, even though sometimes did not get a thing, we were happy with the joy the day would bring. Sneaking out the back door to hang out with those hoodlum friends of mine. We were greeted at the back door with sun. I told you not to go outside. Yeah. Trying our best to bring the water to our eyes, hoping that might keep her from whipping on behind. I wish those days would come back once more. Why did those days ever have to go? I wish those days would come back once more. Why did those days ever have to go? That I love them so.
I'm thinking today about Birdland, and I think we're all familiar with the great names who grace the stage, the celebrities, the stars of the jazz world. We're probably less familiar with the names of the brilliant side men and side women who've accompanied those stars over the decades. Birdland has given them a home to practice their art, to earn a living, to support their families. I know about sidemen because my dad was a trumpet player and a sideman. He loved Birdland, as do I. And I'm grateful today for any support we can give. We need to keep Birdland and other clubs alive through this difficult time so that musicians have a home, a place to practice their art, and to earn a living and support their families. So thanks for any help you can give.
If you're just now joining us, we hope you're enjoying Save Birdland, a celebration of music, hope, and community. I'm Paul Cavalcante, and next up, we have one of the hottest groups on the scene. Here's the Emmett Cohen Trio.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle Poole on the drums, Russell Hall on the bass, and yours truly, Emmett Cohen on the piano.
Hey, aloha from beautiful Maui. This is Frank Wildhorn. Birdland is sacred. Birdland is a holy place. Growing up, Birdland was where I would go to see all my idols play and make me fall in love over and over again with the form, the jazz, the magic. And when I got a chance to play there with great singers and great bands consistently over the years, what a thrill, what a high. Some of my great moments I've had in my life musically has been playing at Birdland. And it cooks, and Birdland should be forever and ever and ever. Thank you so much.
Greetings. This is drummer Steve Smith. Birdland has such an intimate environment. I hear those instruments, those musicians, the sound is coming off stage directly into my ears without microphones, without the need for a sound system. The sound is beautiful and the vibe has been so developed over the years. So much music has happened at Birdland. The molecules in the room have changed this space into really like a sacred temple for jazz to be performed. And it's so important to be part of live music. And when I say part of, I mean that. When you go as an audience member to listen and witness and be part of live performance, your feedback influences the musicians on stage. It's such an incredible place, employs lots of musicians, and it employs lots of other folks too. And the bartenders, the wait staff, the cooks. This is an amazing musical venue, and we need to save Birdland. So join me in supporting Birdland Jazz Club in New York City. Thank you.
This is Hillary Cole on Save Birdland.
This is a Michel Legrand composition, and I thought it was apropos of the moment. I was able to perform this many times at Birdland, and it's a little sad, a little sweet, but also, I hope, a little hopeful.
Feeding in the square have flown.
I'm Paul Cavalcante. We hope you're enjoying tonight's presentation to save Birdland. Next up, we have a performance from the one and only Marilyn May.
Hey, Marilyn.
Hi, Marilyn.
Hi there. Hi there, Michael. Hi, Tom. I'm glad to see you.
Oh, we're so glad to see you.
Yes, we wish you could be here in person because we would have loved to have filmed you at Birdland.
Nothing like Marilyn May at Birdland.
I wish I could, too.
And where are you?
I'm in Kansas City right now at Gem Theater, the wonderful theater that's in the Jazz District of Kansas City. You know, it's across from the American Jazz Hall of Fame. And the theater seats 500, and there's nobody in any of those seats.
We hear you. We know. We feel
just cameras, it. Which we're grateful for doing a virtual and glad that we could join you for a minute.
So you have a number for us?
I'd love to sing something for you.
Oh, my goodness. So you're going to send us a number?
It's a very it's a very meaningful song, especially now.
Oh, I'm so excited. Nothing like a Marilyn May number. Then we won't keep you busy. We'll let you go do the number.
I'd love that. Thank you.
All right, Marilyn. Thank
you. Cheers to you, and thank you for doing this, you guys.
Yay, let's save Birdland.
Yay, Marilyn May.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, for everyone. Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb. There are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there is just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, for everyone. Lord, we don't need another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow. There are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to shine. Oh, listen, Lord, if you want to know, let me tell you so. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there is just too little of. What the world really needs now is love, sweet love now. No, not just for some. We need it for everyone, yes, for everyone. We don't need another mountain. We don't need another river. We don't need another cornfield. We need love. We need love. We need love. Oh, listen to me, Lord. Can't you hear me when I say what the world needs now is love?
Hi, everybody out there. You know, I've always been proud of the fact that I'm in the entertainment business. I've been a performer all my life. And singing is my way of survival. And in all my years, I've never stopped. The survival of Birdland is really important to me. And to all the singers and the great musicians who bring the joy of living, which is music, to everyone in the audience. I have to say that Birdland and Birdland Theater provides the music so necessary for our way of living. You know, all of you out there understand this, and I join all the artists you've met today who say thanks, and I say thanks to you. Birdland is New York. We must save it. What the world needs now is your love and your generous support, and we all thank you so much.
Hi, everybody. Steve Tyrell here, and I want to give a personal shout out with plenty of love to Birdland. It is one of the most legendary music venues in all the world, and we're lucky to have it, and we must keep it going. All of us help out and keep Birdland swinging for the next 100 years.
This is Rhonda Hamilton. Next up on Save Birdland, a celebration of music, history, and community, we have something really special for you. With Glenn Selesky on keys, here is Ravi Coltrane with Lush Life.
Thank you.
brought you downstairs to the Birdland Theater. This is a space we built about 2 years ago. Amazing things have happened here. But first, I want to show you backstage. Here, come this way. Little insidery moment. This is the dressing room. Some great, great people have been naked in there, no doubt. And if we go down this hall, this is the green room. Cool things have happened here. Okay, now this is backstage. I love backstages. On the other side of this drape, incredible things have happened on the stage. Jazz, cabaret, pop, theater, burlesque. And every Tuesday night, we do a show called The Lineup, hosted by the insane, the fabulous Susie Mosher. So let's, here, come on this way. Come on.
Look, oh, here we are. Susie.
What are you doing here?
Jim! What? Hey! I didn't expect to see you today.
I'm so surprised. I had no idea.
Well, yeah. You know,
I come here every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, sometimes Sunday, just to make sure that, you know, things are ready to go when we are back in production.
You clean the place?
I do, yeah. It calms me down. You know, I've had a lot of jitters this year, you know, concerns about the future.
I understand. Oh, I did not know. Well, thank you.
Well, my pleasure. You know what, Jim? We don't spend enough time together. We just don't. I don't know enough about you, Jim Caruso. For instance, let's see. I'm going to ask you some. What was the first show you ever saw at Birdland? Mine was Cast Party. Okay. What's your favorite sort of standard jazz song? Mine is going to be Misty. I'm going to say Misty. What do you remember the first time you ever fell in love? Boy, I do. Yeah. His name was Norm. And he was the drummer in this little combo that I worked with in San Diego at Corsaro Strictly Jazz. And he was Italian and had this thick, wavy black hair and sort of sinewy and muscular. And every woman that came into the club was obsessed with him. They fell instantly in love with him. You know, they would write little notes to him on napkins and then they'd follow him into the bathroom and mash him against the wall and try and make out. But for some crazy reason, Norm liked me, which had never happened before, where the most desirable person in the room wanted me. So I was just on cloud nine. I'd never felt happier in my life. I was so elated and happy at all times. And it was such a wonderful time. I remember, you know, after the gig, we'd go back to his apartment and we would play records and smoke pot and eat sandwiches from the Hoagie Hut. And yeah, it was maybe one of the best times of my life. And then one day he called me on the phone and he said that he loved me as a friend and that he was in love with Sally, the new leggy, beachy, blonde waitress at Corsaro's. In fact, he was moving in with her that weekend. I was slammed. I was crushed. I was devastated. It's like all I did really for the next couple of months is like lie on the couch drinking vodka and orange juice, watching MTV, seriously considering it every time Van Halen urged me to jump. Go ahead, jump. Might as well jump. And then after a few months of that, one morning I woke up and I brushed my teeth, and I brushed my hair, and I got out of my moo-moo, and I got back into life, like you do. And then a few weeks later, I get the phone call. It's that same sexy, whispery voice. Hey, babe, how you doing? Been thinking of you. Wondering if you want to get a drink. Grab a sandwich. Now you say you're lonely. You cry the whole night through. Well, you can cry me a river. You can cry me a river. Because I cried a river over you. Now you say you're sorry for treating me untrue. Well, you can cry me a river. You can cry me a river. Because I cried
a river over you. You drove me out of my head while you never shed a single tear. Remember? Uh-oh, I remember what it was you said. Told me love was too plebeian. You told me you were through with me. And now you say you love me. Well, just to prove that you really do, why don't you cry me a river? Come on, cry me a river. Because I cried a river over you! S-I-P-P, I cried a river. True story.
This is Save Birdland with Rhonda Hamilton. You're on the air.
Hello, this is Perez Hilton, and I am loving tonight's show, and I love New York and Birdland. Can you play Angel Eyes next?
Sure thing, Perez. Straight from their sold-out Birdland engagement, here are the ever-adorable Diana DeGarmo, Ace Young, with Slim Gamble and Angel Eyes.
Devil sent. Broadway theaters, off-Broadway theaters, cabaret clubs, comedy clubs, and of course, jazz clubs like Birdland are essential to the cultural fabric of our city. And now more than ever, live performance venues need support to survive. My office's report on the creative economy shows that the cultural sector is a major economic engine for our city, directly and indirectly sustaining thousands of New Yorkers and their families, actors, musicians, technicians, stagehands, dressers, designers, and so many more. And when visitors come from every corner of the world to experience the vibrancy of New York City's cultural sector, they eat, shop, and explore across the five boroughs too. The loss of live entertainment due to the pandemic and the shutdowns have impacted countless New Yorkers, many of whom haven't worked since March. Many have lost their health insurance and are struggling to make rent or put food on the table. That's why it's so important that we fight for an equitable economic recovery that revitalizes our live performance venues and supports the thousands of talented New Yorkers that keep this industry alive. The show must go on.
Joe Iconis and family is next on Save Birdland.
Hi, I'm Joe Iconis. I'm down here at the theater at Birdland, and I'd like to do a song now written by a friend of mine who is a great believer in major chords. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it. New York, New York. I wanna wake up in a city that doesn't sleep. It's up to you, New York, New York. You know it too. Everybody knows the song, man. And now, oh, karma. New York, New York. I wanna wake up in the city that doesn't sleep.
Hi, I'm Dee Dee Bridgewater, and I am here to extol the merits and the beauty of Birdland. Birdland is going through some very difficult times. We have seen some jazz clubs close, most recently the Jazz Standard. We cannot let this happen to Birdland. So please, everyone, if you are listening, if you've got any change in your pockets at all, could you please spare some of it to help keep Birdland's doors open? I just want to say to you, Gianni, and to everybody from Birdland that we are in this together. We're in this love together. We gotta make it last forever. Oh yes, that's what we gotta do now. I'm with you and we're in this love together. And it's like berries on the vine. It gets sweeter all the time. Everybody's gotta dig in your pockets, get out some change now. You gotta give what you can to save this club. Yes, you can now. These are trying times and we have got to find a way to keep together. And jazz is one way that we do it. The Birdland is the place we do it. Everybody, please, please, please help us keep the doors open to Birdland, please. I'm Dee Dee Bridgewater.
15 years ago, I walked into Birdland and basically never left. It is truly my home away from home. And Johnny Valente and Jim Caruso are family, my dear, dear friends. Many years ago, Jim asked me if I would do my songwriter series as part of their Broadway series, which is kind of funny. And I started to do that like two or three times a year at Birdland for the last 15 years. But a few years ago, a producer came in and saw the show and asked if he could run with it. And the next thing I know, I had an all arts channel PBS TV show called Songwriters Under the Covers with Victoria Shaw. Lots of amazing things happen at Birdland and because of Birdland. And I'm so honored to be a small part of this wonderful evening. And I'm going to leave you with this song that we shot for the TV show at Birdland. It's a song I wrote with my friend Garth Brooks. It's about never giving up, always going ahead with dreams, because that's what this night's about. I love you, Johnny. I love you, Jim. And just so happy that this is happening. God bless.
You know a dream is like a river, ever changing. Trying to learn from what's behind you, never knowing what's in store, makes each day a constant battle just to stay between the shores. And I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry, like a bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Too many times we stood aside and let the water slip away. While we put off till tomorrow has now become today. So don't you sit upon the shorelines and say you're satisfied. Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance that tide. And I will say, I'll never.
bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry.
Everybody.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Desmond Child is next on Save Birdland.
I'm going to sing you one of the most meaningful songs I've ever written. I wrote it for Barbara Streisand, and she was doing an album called Walls, which is all about what's been going on right now and how we should be building bridges instead of building walls. And I thought of her a lot, and I listened to all of her music before I started writing the song. But the image that kept coming to my mind was the image of Barbara on a tugboat in Funny Girl crossing in front of the Statue of Liberty. And there it was, these two strong, triumphant, patriotic women. And I just said, I have to write a song called Lady Liberty, because that's what Barbara Streisand is to me, Lady Liberty. Lamp of hope a little higher. Burn that flame of freedom just a little brighter, please, for all the world to see and still believe. Oh, Lady Liberty, show us how to stand and feel a little prouder. When the anthem plays, let's sing and raise our voices even louder, since the real danger lies in the sound of silence. Lady Liberty, I see you rise above the crashing waves, bearing witness to our darkest days, like that terrible September when we stopped and cried together. Tired and you're poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. The wretched refuse of your teeming shore, send these the homeless, the tempest tossed, to me, to me. So lift your lamp and lead us through the golden door. Tell the whole damn universe there's room for all of us and more forever. Lady Liberty, my country tis of thee. Lady Liberty,
the world to see.
Hello, folks. I am Monty Alexander, piano player, right? I first came to New York City in the early 60s, and I had a job right up the street from Birdland. And I would have the opportunity to go to Birdland as a 19-year-old and to see these great men of jazz that laid down the foundation for the music that we have. I saw Duke Ellington, I saw John Coltrane, I saw Horace Silver, I saw Art Blakey, and that thrilled me to no end. And just to think that Birdland is still going. So I am here among other people to encourage you people who love this music and care about the future of this music to go out of your way a little bit and contribute to a special fund, which is called SaveBirdland.com website. You can see all the information there. So thank you for listening. And hey, here's a tune I just remembered. By Birdland. We're gonna keep Birdland alive. Save Birdland. Save Birdland.
Here are some fun facts that you might not know about the legendary Birdland.
The club was originally set to open September 8, 1949, but they had to delay 2 months to get a liquor license.
The original venue seated 500 and had a stage big enough for a full orchestra.
It also had a fenced-in bullpen, which was nicknamed the Peanut Gallery, where underage teenagers were allowed to sit and watch.
The original home of Birdland on 52nd Street closed in the 60s. It is now a strip club.
And they say they cleaned up Times Square.
The current home of Birdland was originally owned by Warner Brothers.
Before it was the theater at Birdland, the downstairs was a Technicolor processing plant.
The main level was a storage facility.
And upstairs was a recording studio.
John Lennon actually did his final recording in that studio right before he went home and was fatally shot.
Tony Williams, Hank Jones, Oscar Peterson, Jim Hall, and several others played their final shows at Birdland.
The oldest person to grace the stage was Irvin Drake at 94 years old.
The youngest person ever to perform at Birdland was only 4 years old. It was actually me. I don't want anyone coming after my title. Here's a picture.
There have been 9 Elphabas who have played Birdland.
2 Osmonds.
1 member of the Village People.
And me? I got to play there once.
Firemen stormed Susie Mosher's The Lineup during a false alarm.
Here's a picture of Marilyn May with one of the firemen she found particularly attractive.
Lionel Richie once played an invite-only concert for fans.
Sadly, it didn't last all night long.
You know the saying, break a leg?
Of course.
Yeah, I know it. I literally broke my leg right before I stepped on the Birdland stage once. Then I did the show, then I sold CDs, then I went to the ER.
Number of hula hoops on stage at a single time? 50, by Malia Walsh.
Number of ukuleles on stage at the same time? 11.
4 EGOTs have appeared on the Birdland stage.
Miss Liza, with a Z, Minnelli, Mr. Jonathan Tunick, Mr. Harry Belafonte, and Mr. Bobby Lopez.
On Sesame Street, Coots the Owl runs a jazz club called, you guessed it, Birdland.
Fact, by donating to the link on the Save Birdland website, you can ensure that the music at Birdland will survive this rough patch.
And for that, we are very grateful.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey guys, this is Matt Baker, and I'm taking you back to 2015 when we could all perform for a packed Birdland house. This is a little snippet of my trio playing Satin Doll. I hope you enjoy it. And I can't wait to perform for you guys again and be with you all again and celebrate music in the not too distant future. See you.
Hi, I'm John Bikino. I'm a songwriter, and I've performed many, many times at Birdland, so I'm thrilled that the community is coming together to support this important New York cultural institution. Jim Caruso asked me if I would contribute one of my songs to this wonderful benefit, and coincidentally, we've just put together a benefit concert honoring the 20th anniversary of the release of my Grateful CD. That concert will air until January 31st, and tickets are available at johnbikino.com. So here to sing one of the songs from that concert is the incredible Leslie Odom Jr.
Lovely party, let's get us a drink. Listen, smarty, don't tell him what you really think. Think of your career and tell him what you think he wants to hear. My, but you're taciturn, now wouldn't you rather earn some brownie points saying the appropriate things? Stuck up like a good little guest, praises in order, best to lay it on thick before the fat lady sings. I advise from first-hand experience that mighty old egos like his expect to be fluffed. So please unbite your tongue, sir, and while the night is young, sir, come up with something or your goose will be stuffed. Eloquent, tell him his opinion has meant more to the masses than the prose of Gabron. Hang on his every word, but said you have never heard a soul who is wittier, and try not to yawn. Yes, I know, you think he's an imbecile, but one mix from him could kill your corporate plan. Don't assume I mislead you. Don't you, the hands that feed you, follow your pride. He's such a powerful man. Yes, you're choking on every syllable, but you can dish out the bowl if anyone can. Trust me, this way is better. Sure, there are Irish that are smarter than him, but he's a powerful man.
Hello, I am Sam Sanchmit.
Hello, I am Pierre Blanchard.
Hello, I'm Ludovic Beyer.
Hello, I'm Antonio Lucuzate. And he is Doudou Cuillerier.
We are the Django All-Stars from France.
Birdland is our second home in the US for mostly 20 years and part of our history.
We hope that everyone will support the jazz corner of the world.
And that we will be back on stage soon. We love Birdland.
We love Birdland.
We love Birdland.
We love Birdland.
We love Birdland. Vive la musique. Simplement.
Enjoying tonight's show. I'm Christine Pedi, and our next performer has had a very diverse career. You might know him from his work on stage and film, but we know him from his sold-out engagements at Birdland. Here is Jeff Daniels. Thank you.
I don't want to get all heavy. I don't mean to bring you down, but I ain't ever, never drove no Chevy. Ain't about to drive one now. You see, I've been mistreated. Someone's done me wrong. My self-esteem is so low, my very existence is all but gone. What might you ask? It's the contributing factor. Real people, not actors. I don't want to hear how the world works, 'cause I know how to make a buck. Just ain't no excusing your reason for using artistic discrimination to sell a truck. Don't worry, I ain't into vengeance. I ain't out for blood. But God, would I give to be able to go up to my local Chevy dealer and just knee him in the nuts. My raison d'etre, my main benefactor, real people, not actors. Lifelong entertainer with a lawyer on retainer. Top of my list, little cease and desist, which he said is a legally binding no-brainer. Just like Max was a factor, John Deere's a tractor, that bearded little cat who's in every single ad. Guess what? He's an actor. It's the daily defamation, your relentless, redundant refrain, aired all across the nation, my little televised ball and chain. Oh, but I've led many an expedition to the heart of the human condition. The last I knew, I was as real as you, so stick that up your ignition. Forgiveness comes easy once you've evened the score. So from now on, Chevy, you can kiss my Ford. Real people. Real people. Real people. Let's all hope we're all back at Birdland real soon.
Hello, Birdland. Tom Seals here, British piano player and singer. And I'm here at the incredible Dubai Opera. I'm so thrilled to be part of this virtual concert. And of course, we're gonna save Birdland. When I was asked to give you a little tune, I was asked what Birdland meant to me. What it means to me is to sit there on one of the most famous stages in the world. And as a piano player, you sit at the piano, and when you're playing, nothing else matters. You can lose yourself. You lose yourself in the history of the room, the people that have played there. And I want to thank Jim Caruso for giving me my first chance to play Birdland about 5 years ago. Last year, I was meant to be back with my own band. It didn't happen because of the pandemic, but hopefully, fingers crossed, I'll be back this year. And I want to echo the words that everybody else has said as part of this show. I'm thrilled to be here, and I can't wait to see you guys again. Some folks like to get away. They take a holiday from the neighborhood. Help a flight to Miami Beach or to Hollywood. Well, but I'm taking the Greyhound the air on the Hudson River line. Because I'm in a New York. Well, I'm in a New York state of mind, but I'm bothered. Myself, Tom Seals, everybody in the Tom Seals band, and I know my friends at home in London at Ronnie Scott's are wishing you all the best as well. Hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.
When I was a young man and living in New York City and I had friends or family visiting, I'd always take them to Birdland, because when you walk into Birdland, you're not just walking into a jazz club, you're walking into a piece of jazz history. So what we're trying to save here is not just a restaurant bar with some music. What we're trying to save here is a piece of Americana. So please, do what you can and help us to save Birdland.
Hey there, I just want to take 2 seconds and thank all of the musicians who are playing, the performers, everybody who's shown up for this thing. And I also really want to thank the folks who've given a bunch of money, and mostly the folks who've given just a little bit of money. You know, a lot of performing artists, we haven't worked since March, February of last year. And these are tough times. We're in kind of the dark night of the COVID crisis. But like the dark night, we're starting to see little stars of hope shine through the darkness, and that hope is coming from you, from your charity, your willingness to be of service, to make sure we don't come back to a ghost town, but we come back to the places that we know and love. And you know, every time you help save one of these venues, you're not just saving a place for artists to perform, you're also saving jobs for busboys and bartenders and cooks. You're helping put money into the linen services and the food purveyors. You're saving little engines of the economy so we can come back quicker and stronger. And we only do that by coming in together, by working together, giving together. So I want to thank all of you. And I want to thank the folks. If you're somebody who can't give right now, I really want to thank you for being here collectively with all of us. so appreciate you, and thank you.
Hi, everybody. We are the Manhattan Transfer, and we got our start in the greatest city in the world, New York City.
You know, as all of you know, recorded the song that Joe Zawinul wrote, that Weather Report originally recorded, Birdland, and we have a lyric that John Hendricks wrote. And John tells a story. He tells the whole story about Birdland, about everybody that played there, all the musicians, all the great singers, musicians that passed through there, you know? So it's historic. It's something that we absolutely have to try and keep alive.
I personally have so many memories of playing at Birdland. Here's one with Moxie, sitting on the bar with Laurel Massé, Cheryl Bentinck, and myself.
Yes, absolutely. We do have great memories there. By the way, they added a bottom floor, which is great as well. I played there. I know you played there, Janis.
Also, I went to Ann Hampton Calloway's wedding at Birdland. I've done a lot of shows there. I sat in with tap dancer Luke Hawkins at Cast Party.
I mean, this club is historic. It's legendary. And it's got to stay open.
Birdland, a swinging Birdland.
Hey, man, the music really took me off.
You know, and hearing about all these, oh man, it's really depressing. The stories that we're hearing about the clubs that just haven't been able to make it. It's just hard for me to wrap my head around that they aren't going to be there anymore. So I hope we can do anything that we can to help this one stay around.
All of us need this room, audience and artists alike.
There was a light at the end of this tunnel, and I know with Birdland, you know, there have been times when, you know, Birdland had closed down and Birdland reopened, and I trust that there will always be a Birdland.
Please support this incredible issue. Let's keep Birdland alive. We love you, Johnny Galante. Thank you for everything you've done.
Thank you, Johnny.
For the jazz scene.
Hang in there. Thanks, everybody.
Keep it going.
This is Sting. So, can you imagine Paris without the Eiffel Tower? Rome without the Colosseum? Giza without the pyramids? London without Buckingham Palace? Well, try and imagine New York without Birdland. It's heritage, musical heritage. What really made America great was jazz music. We have to save Birdland.
I'm Rhonda Hamilton, and this next act is sure to have you tapping your toes. Straight from the jazz corner of the world, we have Wynton Marsalis with the Arturo O'Farrell Quintet.
Thank you. McDonald here. Thank you so much for being with everybody tonight and doing what you can to make sure we save Birdland. Birdland needs us, and we need Birdland. It is a place of joy. It is a place of incredible artistry. It is a place where you can watch stars being born. It's a place where you can see stars continuing to shine. It is a place where the great appreciation of American music and jazz and true artistry lives. And music makes us human, doesn't it? And we need Birdland. I had the great joy of playing Billie Holiday a couple of years ago in Lady Day at Emerson's Bar and Grill. After having done a lot of research on Billie Holiday, how much certain venues meant to her. The joy of being in certain spaces was something she carried in her heart, and I know Birdland was one of those places. And so I would just end with saying that we must save Birdland. I guess I'll just end with a little bit of Billie. I know I don't look like her right now. Close your eyes, maybe you'll hear her. Them that's got shall have, them that's not shall lose. So the Bible says, and it still is news. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own. That's got his own. Save Birdland.
With the Johnny Mathis classic, here is Norm Lewis with Billy Stritch and Misty.
Hello, everyone. I am so honored to be here. This place, Birdland, has been a staple in our history for so many years. It has started careers, and it's also been a place where a lot of stars have fought to be here. Like I said, it's been around for a lot of years, and we are all here collectively to make sure that it stays even more years. I'm going to do a song called Misty, and on piano we have Mr. Billy Stritch, and on the bass we have Mr. Tom Hubbard. I'm as helpless as a kitten up a tree, and I feel like I'm clinging to a cloud I can't understand. I get misty just holding your hand. And a thousand violins begin to play. Or it might be the sound of your hello, that music I hear. I get misty the moment you're near. You can say that you're leaving. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? That's why I'm following you. On my own, but I wander through this wonderland. My right foot from my left, my hat from my glove. I get misty and too much in love. guess I get misty and too much in love. Look at me.
I'm Rhonda Hamilton.
I'm Paul Cavalcante.
This is Emilio Sanchez.
This is Christine Petty.
Thank you for watching tonight's presentation, Save Birdland,
a celebration of music, history, and community.
For our last act tonight, we have a rising star on the scene.
From her new album, This Bitter Earth, here is Veronica Swift.
This bitter earth, what fruit it bears, this bitter earth. If my life is like the dust, ooh, that hides the glow of a rose, what good am I? Heaven only knows. This bitter earth can be so cold. Today you're young, too soon you're old. Ooh, that high.
What good am I? Heaven only knows. I'm sure someone may answer my call. And this bitter earth.
When a venue like Birdland goes dark, it affects not only the artists who play there, but the wait staff, the bartenders, the kitchen staff, and on, it affects the community. But look at what our community did tonight, how well we all responded. Together, we've raised hundreds of thousands of dollars so that live music in New York City can play on. That's remarkable. That's because of you. Because of you, the show will go on. Thank you all for saving Birdland. See you at the club.
Whisper low, kiss me sweet, then we'll go flying.